Sorry guys, I know you want to get right to the tank review, but I just want to say real quick this. I did not buy these new premium tanks that came out in the store. A friend actually gave this to me, like the Warlord we're going to about to review, and another tier 3 premium tank we're going to be reviewing soon in the next thing. I'll show it what it looks like at the end, but basically I did not buy the tank, so I hold my own prowess, and the reason why he did this, even though despite the fact I told him they maybe not be a good tank, and we'll look into it and I'll show you everything what I mean. The reason why I do this is because I made a promise to him that I will get Sea of Thieves. So that's right. So probably next 3 weeks from now, this guys, I may go join Sea of Thieves and might do a YouTube video on that. So I hope to look forward to seeing you guys there. And also, just to let you know, the King Dragon's way better now. They gave it more better armor. Well, not armor. They gave it more better gun to pen through tier 10. So it's a lot better tank. That's why I was hovering over it a little bit. So without further ado, let's get into the review. And hopefully see you in a couple of 3 weeks playing Sea of Thieves. See you then, guys. Another goddamn premium tank. I'm getting sick of this. Like, another fucking premium tank. What is it, another fucking 8? Oh, that's jolly all good. We just went through fucking 3 of them just right now, and now we're bringing out another one? You goddamn piece of... What? It's a 7? It's not an 8? Hallelujah! It's a fucking 7! What does it look like? The Warlord? Okay, let's see what it looks like. No! Okay, just play the intro. We'll be right back. do this. No! What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? Oh my god. This is the most funniest paint job I've ever fucking seen on a premium tank. Wow. Just wow, Japanese. Really? Really? You took our most legendary panther and you turned it into this golden fucking power in the hood kind of tank? Like, what? No! This is World War II, not fucking today's fucking gangster show-off tanks. That should be like a game right there. Gangster show-off tanks. Just have gangster hood paintings all over the tanks. Oh, man. Okay, I gotta get serious here. Oh, fuck. This warlord. Oh, man, I'm sorry, guys. Just, wow. Just come on one day, and then all of a sudden, here's this tank, and it's like, what the fuck is this? Alright, let's all seriousness aside. We got a lot to really talk about. Okay, basically, it's just a regular stock panther on a Japanese thing. I mean, I've got to reveiw it because, like, if you don't know the panther, I'll quickly go reveiw it. Basically, the armor, for the whole armor, is only 75, but plus angle, that's almost like 90 almost. So pretty much it can block pretty much tier 7 guns easily, but you got to be really crafty with it. The top part of the tank is like completely weak, obviously, because it's flat surface. Then that lovely golden commander's hatch has 121 millimeters. So, penning that with a weak gun with a tier 5 is not going to pen that easily. Not to mention the head itself is pretty much 120. Because it's basically got that frontal plate armor and pretty much the gun round circle bit. And basically the side of the tank is pretty much 50 millimeters. While the tracks and stuff is only 30 with a little side skirts on the side being only 20 millimeters. So, penetrating through the tracks, then penetrating through the skirt armor, it's a lot more armor, up to 51 almost. Plus, not to mention, penning through the tank is also 51, so it's almost 100 if you pen straight through that side. So just be mindful to where you shoot. Not to mention, it has a little space armor, so if you shoot like golden rounds on the side and hit that little plating that's like a really square line shown right there, it may have a hard time penning it if you don't have a very good penning howitzer gun. Like, say, for example, like tier probably 4s or tier probably 5s with little small howitzer guns. So just be keep in mind, just to keeping an eye on that. Alright, let's talk about the modules. Alright, horsepower, 870. Power ratio is 19.97. Forward speed 55, reverse speed 20, chance of fire 20. Now, be careful with the fire bit because, like I said, there's no armor, so you have to keep that engine safe because one good bullet does hit that thing, it's like it's going to set that thing on fire really badly because Germans like to use a lot of electricians in electricity in their tanks. And, oh boy, they were not designed to build very fair to basically keep the tanks from not being, you know, engine failures, broke downs, and freaking getting set on fire. So just be mindful of that. But also, it has the good Panzer speed, so you can able to flank around targets, so that's a good plus. Now let's talk about the gun. The gun's reloading time is 4 seconds, which if you got a good crew and stuff like that, like I do, it'll be almost down to 3.30. Aim time is 2.30. Again, it's okay, but you're going to see why I'm going to have that problem in a second. Accuracy at 100 millimeters, 0.35. Accuracy on the move is 0.51. Accuracy during rotating speed is 0.91. Maximum range is 720. Maximum elevation is 18. Maximum depression is 8. Now the radio, I have to say real quick before I show you in the little clip battle to show like what all this means, so that way you can see, for example. Spotting is way less than a regular Panther. Like, this is only 73. The Panther pretty much, I think, has like 89. Hang on, let's look that up, shall we? Alright, let's get rid of the premium. And look at the original Panther. Oh, I guess it does have the same spotting range. I thought it like had like something a little bit less than that. Oh yeah, it does. Okay. I was gonna say, yeah, the spotting range is only 78 when you fully upgrade it. Well, this tank only has 73. But is it the same as stock? Let's see. Let's see, stock and stuff. Nope. Because it's stock, it's way worse. But when you fully upgrade it, you automatically get the 78 spotting range. So yeah, this one suffers a lot more spotting range than on the other tank. Now, let's go to the battlefield so I could show you pretty much how this gun works, how far you have to shoot it, and I'm going to also explain later on why it has a little problem with that. Okay, guys, here we are in the little testing ground to show you the tank of how much hit points. As you can see, it's only 1,200. There's all your crew, all your modules, and basically the reloading is basically again 3.30 because I have a good damn crew in it with along with gun rammer and ventilations, which is what you want for this tank because you want to shoot them down really fast. Now, the problem is with this tank, it does less damage, so it's meant to be sitting in the back while keeping the enemy at bay to make sure that your allies that are weaker or stronger do not fall. So it's basically a toothpicking tank that just shoots really fast. And God, I'm not used to that Japanese crew in a Panther. I'm sorry, it's like, what the frig? And I'll turn around a little bit. And the problem is, I'll talk about the bullet pen in a minute, but there's a reason why the bullet pen, I'm not gonna lie, because if someone angles their tank, it's really hard to do it. Okay, let me try showing the rotating turret. Okay, so it's mediocrely average. It's not fast, not too slow, so it's not bad. Now let's do the head rotation. As you can see, it's very fast, but not like it's like averagely fast, so you'll be able to catch up with light tanks easily. But like again, only doing 113 damage, you gotta make sure you have someone else helping you with it, otherwise you wouldn't be able to kill it. All right, let's show how fast it can go by climbing up this hill right here. Hang on, let's turn around. Turn this bad boy around. Or this bling bling tank around. All right, let's head forward, climb up the hill and see how fast it can go. Now, for starting up the engine, it's a little bit off, so but once it gets going, it's actually pretty good speed. Now let's see how much we lose going up the hill. So yeah, it reduces its speed pretty fast because of the engine in it, but all in all, it's an okay speed, but it's not fast enough to dodge mediums and heavies like light tanks. So its best bet is, like I said, play as a sniper tank like most, Panther players do. All right, let's head back to the garage to continue the review. Okay, welcome back, guys. Now let's talk about the tracks. Rotating speed is only 32. Like basically this picks up pretty good for a medium tank. So again, most people that like German medium tanks is they're mostly their speed, their accuracy, and the gun pen. Now, track resistance is 1.1, 1, and then 2.3. So, angling this tank is your best bet to block some shit, but be careful though, because you can't block everything. Like, for example, if someone has a tier 8 gun, like, the Tiger 1, the IS, IS-2s, or the ISU 122, so yeah, they're gonna pen right through you, even angled, so just be mindful of that to be careful. Now for the head, viewing range is 370. Again, a lot, little bit less for a Panther, but again, it is a stock version of it, so it's gonna have that kind of problem with it. And rotating speed, 34. I've already showed that in the battlefield, like I was saying. Single range, 550. And pretty much you got a full set of crew with every module in it. The reloader, the driver, the radio man, and everything, the commander and all that, they're all here. There's no uniquely different about it. So now let's talk about the bullets, which I have a major problem with. Now, I get it. Before I begin this, I know Panthers are not designed to damage things quickly. However, where the tiers that it's going and the less armor it has, it does have a huge problem. For example, I'll show you. Regular armor piercings. Damage 101 to 163. I mean 69. Now, when I've been playing this tank, The highest I've ever seen is doing a 139, and that was just bare minimum of damage. I have not seen it go up to 169. If someone has seen it, please let me know. But at the same time, I haven't seen it that much. But for one bullet costs basically 109, which is, you think that's good, but the pen is only 113 to 188. That's the problem I have, because not this tank is designed to snipe, right? So basically the farther away the distance and the more you piss them off at long range, the better you are in a Panther. That's what I know for Panther players. However, due to the fact that it only has 113, the farther away you shoot the bullet, like four grids over, the less pen you do. So it has less of an impact on a target, making armor piercing completely shit, in my opinion, to use. Because trying to shoot something long range with only 113, trying to pin something that far away to make sure it hits without losing that depression of how far it goes, it just doesn't have the impact that it has for a regular Panther. Now, I do be fair, you can pen sevens with this and you can pen some things far away. It's just that me, if you're fighting eights, it's going to be a problem shooting this type of bullet, which is leads to the next bullet, which is capable of it a little bit. Like APCR combat rids is only 147 to 243, but the bullet cost is 2,800. So think about it this way. You only do basically 139 a damage to a tier 8, and you're shooting APCR. That's 2,800. You're going to be losing almost near 50k almost for killing one tier 8. Because you got to think, if you single-handedly kill a tier 8, and most tier 8s have basically 1,800 is pretty much some of their health, or 2,000 for maximum health. And you're telling me for 139, if you get lucky to do that much, sometimes you'll do like 1010, you know, 101, and you're shooting APCR at it. That's a lot of fucking money for a Panther. So that's a huge problem with this. And then high explosives is 131 to 219. Penetration is 29 to 48. Cost of bullet is only 98. I only put 12 on here because, again, if I see an artillery, I'll shoot at it and it will pen it if I hit the very, very weak spot on their, you know, their top plates and stuff like that. And it will do full-fledged damage. Hey, you want to get rid of them as quickly as possible. You don't want to get shotgunned by them. And to me, personally, I don't know, but I'll talk about it at the end, but let's get right into the battlefield, shall we? Okay, guys, with all seriousness aside, here we are in the first match. And, yeah, let's talk about its personal thing a little bit for me since it's going to the battlefield. I don't know why it's even called a Warlord. I don't know why they named it that. Well, there's a lot of things I don't know why they did. Like, the camouflage painting looks beyond weird. But Warlord? Really? Warlord? Like, to me, Warlord should be on like a Tiger 131. It's like, yes, a lot of people don't think that's a good tank anymore since they nerfed it, but at the same time, it still could walk away with nearly 4 or 5 kills if you know what you're doing. So, yeah, Warlord, I don't know why they picked that as a name. But anyway, okay, here we are. The first tank, BK 28.1. And I was moving back because I didn't want to get hit by snipers, so I'm going around the other side. That's basically the strategy you have to do in this tank. You just have to stay as far back as possible. So if you're familiar with the German Panthers, like I said, yeah, it would be basically you stay as far as back as possible from the enemy to shoot at them. And then I come around the corner, gun depression, boop, shoot them on the head. So yeah, even though the gun accuracy is a little bit, like I said, now I'm not used to it because Panthers are not really my specialty, and you're probably wondering, well, Fury, you're a German, why would you not be used to the Panthers? Don't get me wrong, I like Panthers, I like the Panther too, but I'm not really good in the Panthers. I'm only like good with Tigers. So I see an artillery, he's sitting out there in the open. Hit him one time, got damage, Wiz got the kill, that was good. Then I see the SU-8, fired, hit him, I got him right above the gun mantlet, and then I fired again. Missed. Didn't. Couldn't even pen him. So, yeah, I'm sorry you don't see where the bullet's impacting and stuff, guys, but like I said, this is supposed to be the faraway thing. This is what you're supposed to do in this tank, is stay as far away from the enemy as possible to get a shot out. Now, I missed again because, again, the accuracy, but I did hit someone's critical thing in the shadows. I don't know how the fuck that worked. And basically, all their tanks are there. Now, as you can see, only you can see up to literally almost 4 grids over. So seeing up to 4 grids over makes it really useful for sniping, but however, because of that nerf spawning thing on here, it's less than a panther, so you'll be seen by an enemy panther more than you could see any others. Now I'm trying to shoot this guy and basically kept missing the first shot, then boom, finally hit him, only did 137. And that's usually the problem with me with panthers, that I didn't really like them that much, is because they didn't do enough damage, but I could see why they're really fun to play, because you get an extremely accurate gun, and let alone a frickin' reload time faster than a tiger. So yeah, I could see why people would like this tank. Also, I noticed people probably gonna say, like, why did you put the German flag on this like you did with the Atomic last game? It's like, I like this flag. I mean, it's the German Imperial Army flag, but it's not a Nazi flag, it doesn't have the cross in it, it's just the Imperial thing. Germany's allowed to show that on my country, not the swastika one, which, thank God. But I just wanted to point that out because people were saying, like, do you get that flag as well on the tank? No, that's just decorations I put on it. Because honestly, I do like this tank. I really do. It's just Japan needs to stop. We need to stop giving them Japan tanks, honestly. Because holy fucking shit, like, Japan, you, we give you a Tiger, and the Tiger is the worst one in the game. The Tier 6 Tiger for its tier, unless you get into Tier 6s, then you're a god. Then you got the Panther that you fucked up the paint job. Like, what are you doing? This is not what it's a Panther does not have bling bling. Like, I swear to God, I'm like, I'm going to see Flavor Flay come out of there going like, yeah, boy! Like, what? No! Anyway, I'm sniping along and I've been fucking up these tanks. Got 11 pens now, 5 criticals, 2 kills. That's normal. And he fired, just track damage. So angling it sometimes really helps it, even though, despite the fact it's less armor. And it's done. That was quick. So now I will show you the rewards when we get back. And yes, this Panther is really good, but I'm not really good in it. But here's the reward. And here you go, guys. We pretty much got only 66k. Without premium, would be 44k. Now, I have the times 2 bonus because this was actually my first day. I mean, I just got up doing this. And basically, we pretty much got the times 2, which means we only got 1,762 instead of 2,762 for premium. And then we just got 842 in without premium. Even though I didn't do best to most Panthers in the game, I gotta say, for a person that don't really like driving it that much, it's pretty good for its tank. But however, we'll talk about the flaws when I talk about the rating. But here you go. See, like, I've damaged all these tanks. I've damaged the Arty. Pretty much damaged this guy by shooting him in the head. Damaged him. Killed him. And it's basically what I said. It's basically a kill stealer, but it's also just a support tank. So if you see this tank killing a lot of people, you know your team is not doing good, because this tank is not designed to kill things, it's designed to steal things. So let's get back to the garage for the final verdict.
Alright guys, the price to get this tank is pretty much like 10k gold. I know it's 900 and, yeah, there we go. Like, the first one would be almost like 7,950, which is basically going to be almost like basically just the $29.99 and basically the $6.99. So it's not that bad compared for most tanks I've seen. But then again, I've been, like I said, we've just been grateful that it's not an 8. So thankfully, we got actually a deal now that's a little bit better. And my final verdict on this Warlord, I would have to say, now, to be fair, it's not a bad premium tank. I mean, it has premium matchmaking. Let's just get over this real quick. It has premium matchmaking. But however, it fights into a tier 8. The damage only does 132 to 129 is the highest roll I've ever seen in this tank. The gun pen for its normal rounds is complete garbage for pretty much being, hang on, let me look at it one more time again, only 113. Like, for example, the Tiger 131 is the same thing, same accuracy. However, the damage is more, and the pen is 10 plus more. It's able to fight sevens better with its normal rounds compared to the Warlord. And personally, for medium drivers that will like this, I would have to give this probably a 6.9 out of 10. Now, I know what you're thinking. That's pretty damn low compared to most tanks I've reviewed. But hear me out. Like I said, just what I just said, it fights against 8s. Your gun pen is not that great. And there's no hardly good armor on it unless you snipe with it. But the problem is sniping with it, with the weak penetrating bullet, is going to be hard. It's like driving the actual stock Panther. And that's nobody wants to do. Everybody always wants to drive the fully upgraded version so they can actually do more penetration. The damage never changes on the Panther, I get that, but at least you would have had a, like a better penning gun. This has a hard time penning its sevens at long range. I just got lucky in that game with a lot of tanks that were low tiers for heavies and pretty much high tiers for mediums and stuff, but at the very end you saw I missed that, I mean, bounced that one shot off that one medium tank, so it's very hard to drive, but for Panther drivers out there, they will have a smile on their face for having it, but good lord, the paint job. I can't get over that. What the fuck? Like I said, I expect like fucking 50 cents coming around the corner going like, just having like a yo, 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 what's up? Or some homies will be with around this tank. Like, no, not the German Panther. It's like Japan, this is the last time. Like I said in the battle thing, this is the last time we're giving you a German tank. You fucked up the Tiger. You fucked up this. You are not getting any more tanks after this. I mean, shit, what's next? A Tiger II Japanese? Or how about an E-75 Japanese? Or the granddaddy of them all, how about the Panzer fucking, Jag Panzer E-100 Tiger fucking Japanese just fucking rolling out the battlefield? It's like, come on, Japan, you gotta have better tanks than this premium tanks. You gotta. Stop using the German tanks, okay? Alright guys, that's my review on this, and I will see you in the next review with also the light tank that came out. So I'll just give you a little sneak peek what we'll be reviewing next. And of course I accidentally bought it, so we're gonna be... Oh, I should do this, so my bad. There we go. We're gonna be reviewing this tank the next video I do. So I'll see you comrades in the next video. Bye guys!